You know, the end of summer is upon us when the Scotch bonnets are ready. So these are extremely, extremely hot peppers. They take at least 100 days to mature. And these started this week along with the Ajii Dulces and the Ajii Charapitas and the 100 plus day hot peppers. So at this point in the season, there's not a whole lot left that's gonna be new, other than we still haven't really done much with peanuts. So now we're looking for peanuts, winter squash, and a few more obscure peppers, but mostly everything is peaked now. So it's actually, in another couple of weeks, it's gonna be downhill.
No way.
Yes.
Time is against us.
Well, tis the season for things to change. So that's kind of where we're at now. So right now is actually peak flavor for a lot of the summer stuff. And in a few more weeks, the flavor of the summer stuff will start declining, but the flavor of the cool weather stuff will start improving.
Things will get sweeter.
Yeah, the greens will start getting a bit sweeter, a little tastier, less bitter. The texture will be better. But right now is peak season for people to enjoy tomatoes, peppers, in particular, tomatoes and peppers.
Different kinds of basil.
I got it last week.
What'd you cook with it?
Ratatouille.
How do you make a good ratatouille?
I have a, it's in a Mark Bittman recipe, I'm trying to think, I got it from the New York Times, with eggplant, everything's cooked up separately, eggplant, zucchini, white onions chopped up, garlic, tomatoes, and then at the very end, you add some basil.
Wow, they have all of that here.
As a matter of fact, I bought it all here. Tomatoes are great over there, the cherry tomatoes. Very sweet. I also made a gazpacho. With some of the same ingredients.
Yeah.
With the cherry tomatoes, cucumber, green pepper, a cubanelle. Oh yeah, onion, garlic.
What's the cubanelle? Which one is that?
It's, how's this?
Nice.
And delicious.
How do you decide pricing on stuff?
Mostly I decide pricing based on a combination of how much of an item I have and the cost, how much I guess or think the cost is going to be. And the reason for saying that is, unlike when you make a car, at the end of the process you know exactly how much that car costs you to build. But with crops, you don't really know the exact cost of a crop until you harvest every last bit of it and sell it. Then you can figure out the cost per unit. So it's always a moving target for us. There's also market forces that we have to deal with. So for example, this year my shelling beans are sky high price-wise because I'm only yielding about half the yield I normally do. So I have to compensate because they're a very labor-intensive crop, and so far people are paying the price we're asking. And you know, it's not a matter of me just wanting to get greedy. No, I gotta cover my costs. And so on the other hand, certain crops like tomatoes we have an abundance of, so my cost on those is definitely, you know, it's lower than if I had half a year. This year, another thing that I have fairly high price so far and will probably keep relatively high is my ginger. Ginger is a warm season crop and it's been pretty cool. and so I'm not going to get the yield out of it that I would normally get. So that's, in a nutshell, how we price stuff. And we do look at market prices, and I will use market prices as long as they are not below my cost. I try not to sell anything at below cost. I'd rather give it away to City Harvest than to sell it below cost.
You gonna have a good holiday?
I'm certainly gonna try.
Okay.
Yeah, get a day, maybe get a day, maybe get a day and a half off.
Can you handle that?
I am going to try very hard to turn my cell phone off and tell the rest of the farm that they're on their own, they gotta figure things out and be big boys. So we'll see how it goes. Alrighty, we'll see you in about a week or so. Behave, Mr. Peter.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so Jamie just...
yeah, took a little bite off this just to make sure it didn't get mixed up. These can get mixed with the habaneros, unfortunately. But this is an Ajii Dulce pepper. So even though it looks really mean and nasty, it's very sweet, but it also has still all the aromatics of a chili pepper. So it's really kind of something. You should take a bite of this yourself, Peter. There's some of them, sometimes they're known for making people start to go red in the face and sweat a little bit,
but then they realize
that they don't get any of the heat. It's just like that that like Pavlovian conditioning of the chili aromatics.
I thought you were I thought you were punking me.
No,
I know.
I've never done that.
Oh, yet. the hours got to me. Damn you.
There was this one pepper, this little yellow peppers that look so, they look like little berries. They look like they couldn't do any harm at all. But I had a real tolerance for them, so I just popped them in my mouth and not think about it. I gave one to somebody, told them it was sweet, and was like, oh yeah, see? Look, I'm just eating them like they're candy.
Jesus.
I walked away and like, about a minute later, I literally hear the footsteps. He's chasing me down.
Yeah, I'm feeling it. No.
You feel a little heat?
Back of my throat.
Really? No, there shouldn't be any.
It's not, all right.
It's not heat. Well, it's not heat.
There's a little bit of the acidity and the
that's it.
Fruitiness, yeah. If you got some of the seeds, they would kind of, they might, they would probably irritate a little bit.
Yeah, that's the word, seeds.
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks.
There you go.
I gotta go now.
We got 30 minutes to get to a bathroom.
Boom, boom, boom.